be a bully.
I wanna be a bully.
Reporting live from the Queen City. 704-646. You in the mix with them bullies. Sitting on them hot topics. Got all that juicy gossip. Yeah. It must be 9 o'clock because I hear them bullies knocking.
I'm a bully, you a bully, he a bully, me a bully. Would you like to be a bully too? I'm a bully, you
peace
a bully,
from 704 bully, to the world. What's trapping in? This your boy Amir Smith with my co-host Shona Robinson. What's
Hello.
Up, love?
Hi, Amir. How you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. You know, me and wifey just found that little townhouse, so I'm ready to get that thing going.
That's lovely.
That's congratulations.
Wonderful. All right, we're going to go straight into the 122nd news with the lovely and talented Tiffany Taylor.
Here we go. If you enjoy a scary movie, this is one for you. February 19th, the movie The Witch came out, and it is a curious cross between faithful period detail and supernatural wilderness. Check out that film's Satan-inspired ghost, beady-eyed rabbit, and more spooky figures. Now,
huh?
Right, yes, whatever. Anyway, if you like horror movies. Now, this is crazy. Free Kesha is trending. The pop star Kesha has been in a legal battle to break her contract with Dr. Luke, who she claims abused her physically, mentally, and sexually. Today, amid fans' support, the judge denied her preliminary injunction to her case. Wow. And so I was looking at this headline that says Sony is forcing her to work with her alleged producer or she does not work at all. This is wild because not only her career is at risk, but her safety as well.
Wow.
There's a site also that's quoting her, and she says they are asking, does she have creative control? And she says, not really, because what's being put out as singles have just perpetuated a particular image that may or may not be entirely accurate. And she'd like to show the world other sides of her personality. She doesn't just want to come off putting out the same old song and becoming a parody of herself. And she has so much more to offer, and she can't wait until the world gets to hear that. So she struggles with being able to make the music that she wants to make. And I'm hoping
creative
that
control.
Today, yeah. Exactly, with our featured artists, that we can talk about what it feels like to actually have that.
Right.
And that's all I have for you guys today. It was just really interesting to break into our story.
You know, Kesha, she's a weirdo anyway.
That does not dismiss the fact.
It doesn't. I mean, we want everyone to have creative control. Everyone in this room are artists.
Right.
I'm an author. Shona's an author. You're a singer. You know, we all understand art.
Mm-hmm.
But I can remember this woman going to the Grammys wearing a garbage bag as a dress.
But somebody, okay, yes, she has to agree to that.
Yeah.
But someone is, I guess, still behind her saying, this is what is going to move. This is what's going to get you, you know, fans.
Her designer should get fired.
Well,
Tiff.
Yes.
Go ahead, Shona.
Reading is fundamental. Mm-hmm. I can say that all day, every day.
Okay.
Because the contract was there.
Mm-hmm.
Reading is fundamental. You have got to read all fine print.
Mm-hmm.
All of it. And sometimes you're so excited you can't believe it.
Hey, I'm signed.
And you're going to be singing for such and such, such. Reading is fundamental.
Well, okay. Agree. I agree. But that doesn't dismiss the fact of, I guess, what she's going into court for. And so,
yeah.
Well, I guess we're arguing two things. Her creative control.
True.
And her safety as far as, you know, whatever producer's doing.
I was just actually pinpointing her mental stability. Like, she seems to be a little off. Let me ask you a question, though, Tiff.
Mm-hmm.
Why did they say her life was in danger?
They said he's sexually abusing her and then mentally abusing her. Like, that's not good for your whole, you know, your aura and everything.
It is.
So,
I think if he did that, he deserved to get his head bust.
Right.
You know, I'm firmly against any type. My mom was abused by my dad when I was young. So I have a personal stance against men putting their hands on women.
Me too.
So,
I do. And I just don't think you should stay in it. Just walk away. Even if they sue you, you just got to walk away. Because what's more important to you? And since my mind, my body, and spiritually is more important to me, I would just walk away.
You can't put a price tag on peace.
No. And we'll just have to battle it out in court. You can't make me stay somewhere I don't want to be.
That's right.
And then so she's just going to have to leave her career.
Right.
Or at least leave it.
Yeah, I mean, I would just leave it.
Okay,
sometimes
right now.
Sometimes it's always best to build from the ground up. She may have to build from the ground up, but I would do that.
Mm-hmm.
It was just something interesting I saw.
It's very interesting.
Yeah.
I was following that also. Right now, I'd like to go into our sponsors. First, we have some new sponsors today. We have Total Life Changes. They offer 38 affordable all-natural products from nutritional to skincare. Our products offer immediate gratification and can help you lose 5 pounds in 5 days or more. Really? Our question is, who you know and love that needs change one thing about their health? And for more on Total Life Changes, you can contact Venus Matthews, 404-436-1338. And that website address is www.totallifechanges.com. And as always, of course, we are sponsored by the Queen City Bullies LLC,
yay,
which encompasses the magazine, the website where we sell novels, buy one, get one free, as well as the radio show. Hey!
Ooh, that's us.
And we also have a special announcement. We now have an app that you can download to your Android devices, and starting Friday, all of your Apple devices. We also bring it to the forefront, our version of the ebook called Bully Books, B-Books. So now you can stop by the website, download your B-Book, listen to the radio show, buy your novels, buy one, get one free.
Yeah, that's cool. Yes.
Get Tiffany Taylor's Testing 1, 2, 3. And everything is always buy one, get one free. So as we always do every week, www.queencitybullies.com. Come through and support. So right now, we're going to go into the first song. And I chose this song because I want to tell everybody who supports the Queen City Bullies, thank you. We really and truly appreciate you. From myself, Shona Robinson, Tiffany Taylor, the engineer, Neil Harp. We thank y'all for listening every week. And this song here is called Thank You by Maze Music and featuring Shifty Montoya. Joint Thank You by Maze Music featuring the boy Shifty Montoya off the Take 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 soundtrack. Right now, the building, we have 646 Entertainment's own. Yes, I love her music.
Yes.
I'm thankful to have her here. Thank you. We got Anime in the building, y'all. Yeah. What's up, Anime?
Hey, what's up, y'all?
Good. How are you?
I'm doing okay. How you doing?
I'm great, actually. Okay. I'm kind of hot, but I'm good, though.
Kind of hot?
Yeah, just a tad bit.
Okay. 808 Jesus, why don't you get Anime something to drink?
No,
Nah, I'm
he
just
loves
playing.
His name.
Yeah, that 808 Jesus. That for the listeners, 808 Jesus is Anime's significant other, can I say? As
no,
you said,
it
as
makes
you put
him
it
sound like he's a woman. I'm sorry. Don't say significant other.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes, 808 Jesus is anime's side nigga.
That's it.
We're going to put that order. I guess I'll start off the questions, man. We got to stop clowning. Anime. First of all, you have a very unique name. Right.
I do.
I think about anime, I think about Ike going upside Tina's head.
But see, I'm not Tina. That's
of course, I'm not saying nobody going to go up beside your head. I was just going to ask, how did you come up with the moniker Anime? Mm-hmm.
Honestly, okay, Anime, for those who don't know, is Tina Turner's biological name.
True.
So if you watch the movie and the history behind her, her struggle, her music itself showed who she was and what she went through. Without physically saying everything that she went through, and that's just who I am.
That's a beautiful analogy.
Yeah. Right.
Because we get questioned all the time about being the bullies, and they think it's because we bully people, but not at all. We fight against the bully.
Right.
So I dig that.
It's good.
Tiffany, you're our resident artist. Okay. So for Anna May, being a young woman, do you have any advice, guidance?
I would say stay true to who you are. Keep smiling, keep pushing, and know that people here in 646, we support you and we love you.
100%.
So if you need to reach out, definitely do so. And we're going to talk. That's all.
Okay. With that light voice.
Uh-huh.
Did you get drunk for your birthday?
I know. We're not talking about that. Let's bring it back to anime.
I want to see Tiff drunk.
I thought he was talking to me. I was about to say.
Oh, you got a birthday coming?
I do. March 16th.
March? Okay. All
right.
Okay.
A star was born.
Yeah.
Yes, definitely a star. Yes, it was.
Hey, I love that. We played one of your songs.
Which song you play?
Forever.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
yeah.
Man, I love that song. I actually made love to Melissa on that song.
Really?
I mean, I never saw the song as a baby making song. You know, maybe like weddings or something significant events.
We jumped the broom on that joint. You could bet that.
Hey, kudos to you. Hey, props to me. Making baby making music.
I have a question.
What's up?
So, when we were talking about the news earlier as far as creative control, can you talk about what having creative control means to you, and is that something that you have as far as in your music career?
Okay, creative control honestly is transforming the person who you are in your day-to-day life to you as an artist. So not only do you have to incorporate everything that comes with being with an artist, but you also have to incorporate your personal life with that as well. And I feel like your music reflects that completely. If it's not the beats, if it's not the words, if it's something in there, your image, the way you look in front of people, the way you speak, you know, that matters. That's your creative control. So I feel like I do have that in me, you know, with me and myself. I feel like I wouldn't allow someone to take that control away from me just mentally. That would never happen, ever.
Like, okay. I appreciate hearing a young black female like yourself say that, because so often, you know, our young black women are pigeonholed into one stereotype.
Right.
So for you to keep yourself outside the box, I applaud that. Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, we're going to go into one of your songs that I truly, truly enjoy. I wanted to kick this one off because when I heard it in the car coming here, I played it about four times. That song is Anna May. Of course, she's a 646 entertainment recording artist, and it's called Tonight. You tonight.
I'm not
that's Animes tonight. 646 recording artist. I'm feeling that joint right there.
I appreciate it.
I think you wanted to touch on something that Tiffany Taylor mentioned before we went to the song.
I did. Both you and Tiffany Taylor, you know, touched small bases on it. But I want to elaborate to everybody who's listening. Never feel like you have to be in a box or you can never be yourself or you have to follow a stereotype or what's trending. Always be yourself. No matter if you're by yourself, it's better to stand alone than not stand at all.
That's right. True. That's right.
I like that.
My little girl is deep over there.
Yes, she is.
Yeah,
I was listening to your song, and you have a big voice for such a little person.
Yes.
And I know everybody can't see her, but she's a little itty-bitty person.
I'm 5'1 and 3/4, by the way.
Okay. She said, and 3/4. She got that all
matters.
Inches.
That 3/4 matters.
It matters,
yes,
don't
it? Do.
Yes.
110 soaking wet.
No, I'm probably like 115 because I'm 109 dry, you know.
And that's what your shoes. So, that's what your shoes off.
I love her.
Nah, that's what my shoes on.
I love her. Hey. So she's what? That's dry. Remember that.
Dry.
That's dry.
I can feed into that.
Right. How long have you been singing?
I've been singing since like the fourth grade, honestly. Of course, you know, when you're in elementary school, you have to take a music class.
Yeah.
But when you graduate from the fourth grade to the fifth grade, you get to audition for like concert choir.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
And so I was in concert choir in the third grade. So I was like, hey, I'm
ready.
I'm ready. Right. You know, like I'm above all of this. Like this is minuscule. Uh-huh. So at that moment, I knew it was so much ahead of me. Like my future was so bright. And this is me in the third grade. Like, no motivation, nobody motivating me to do or be anything, you know, it was me having
there.
That self-motivation. So I couldn't just let it go to waste at all.
That's important, self-motivation.
Mm-hmm.
So when you're passionate about something, nobody shouldn't have to pump you up or prime you or motivate you. You should be motivating yourself. And if that's something that you can't do, then you have to question whether or not that's something you're passionate about.
Correct. So, true. I agree.
Yeah. You know what I'm enjoying? I'm sitting here right now, and sometimes I forget what an incredible singer Shona Robinson is.
She's
you know,
awesome.
Because
a great speaker. I like
she's
the way
a great
she,
speaker.
You know, when she gives her words,
I'm looking at three generations of singers almost. You know, we got Shona, Tiff, and Anna May, and you know, Shona, is there any kind of advice you can give to these young up and coming women? As far as the direction you went in singing, maybe there's something you wish you hadn't done when you was pursuing some type of singing career?
Well, I never pursued a singing career.
Okay.
I love to sing, but I love to sing for him.
Mm-hmm.
So the only thing that I can say is...
Him with the big H.
Right.
Yes. Exactly.
Okay.
Never sing when you're sick. Ever, ever, ever.
Right.
Ever. I don't care what it is. Don't sing when you're sick.
You tell
me I lost my voice for 2 years because I did it.
Wow.
Oh,
two
goodness.
Years. The money may be there, but if you lose your voice for 2 years,
that's
you're
it.
Not going to have no voice. So if you're sick, make sure you get that taken care of before you're sick and learn how to say no.
When you say
and
sick.
And I'm not talking about concerts. I'm not talking about that. See, I didn't do that. It's just anytime somebody wanted me to sing, I was there.
I know what you're talking about.
A wedding,
graduation,
bar mitzvah, it don't matter what it was. Oh, you want me to say? I was just so honored that they asked. I was running all over the place, just singing, traveling all over and never asked for money because I didn't do it for money. So when somebody blessed me with money, I would give it back because I felt uncomfortable taking money from them. So...
And let me thank you, Shona. Because,
that's me too. I feel uncomfortable receiving
yes.
money from others.
Really?
Yeah. It's crazy, right? Like, why am I in this
I
business?
Yeah.
That doesn't make sense.
Of.
But that's I'm not here for the money. You know, that's just a
they
plus.
Say,
I'm here to do what I love to do.
Something that you would do for free. If you do something that you would do for free, that's what you were meant to do.
So you mean to tell
exactly.
me I'm the only one sitting here doing this for money?
No, you are.
I mean,
like,
I ain't
nah.
singing or nothing.
And it's
but...
not that I don't have nothing to say either, but like I just didn't want to interrupt. But I'm not doing it for the money either. I'm just saying I will gladly receive it.
Yeah, hey. You know, I can't even sing, but if a couple hundred dollars come across the table, I'm going
to
be doo-wopping woo-woo-woo all the way through the goddamn concert. You know what I mean? Thank you, too, Shona, for May 17th, I'm getting married. And Shona Robinson agreed.
Congratulations.
To, yeah. Yay. Everybody's invited. Shona's going to sing
Let's back this up.
Didn't she
you
just
on
say?
The radio and you said everybody's invited.
Oh, no, no, not y'all out there listening. Everybody in the room.
Right, exactly.
Well, a few of y'all out there listening, but everybody's in the room invited.
Okay.
Yeah, but Shona's going to sing one of the Wyan, what's her name? CeCe Winans? Mm-hmm. CeCe Winans' song at the wedding. And I dig that because that's my partner right there. And just seeing her as I'm standing up there ease my nervousness on that day. But go ahead, Tiff.
Anime.
Yes.
Can you tell us where do you see yourself? One question. Where do you see yourself as far as in the next year, as an artist? And two, what distinguishes you from every other chick that's out here?
Okay. First question. Where do I see myself in the next, I'm going to say the next year or two?
Yeah.
Honestly, everywhere.
That's
confidence. Billboards in New York, LA, everywhere. I want to be known for anime. I want people to see me in the store and be like, hey,
that's
recognize
anime.
You. You know, like, are you a singer? And then they'd be like, I'm like, yeah. And they're like, yo, you're anime. You know what I'm like, yeah, that's me. Like, can I have some candy? You know what I'm saying? Like, I want people to know me. And
I caught that, but I
didn't. That was slipped by. Did you say, can I have some cake?
You know what, though?
I said some candy. I don't even eat
anime.
I thought you said some cake. I was going to say, you be feeding her cake. Did you say anime, eat the cake?
Eat that cake.
Did you say anime, eat the cake?
808, you don't be telling her eat that cake.
Stop it, bring it back.
Anime be telling 808 eat that cake. That's what be telling somebody eat cake.
Why?
Hey, look. Let me stop, y'all. Okay, right now we gonna go into anime featuring Young Opdu. All I Know. Let's get it.
This one of my favorite songs.
Okay, that's anime featuring Young Opdu with All I Know. That's a hot joint anime.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. That's probably one of my favorites. Okay. If you actually there while we did that, woo.
It was fire.
It was.
I could tell. Tiffany asked you a question. I think you wanted to finish the
second
part
of your question, right. Tiffany. Correct. You were asking, for those of you who are just tuning in, Tiffany asked, what makes me different from any other female? And honestly, my mindset.
Where you at?
Not here. obviously. But physically, I'm here, but mentally, I'm so ahead of my time.
Okay.
I'm really trying to build my foundation and focus on not only my career, but balancing my career and my personal life.
Mm-hmm.
And
yes.
To where my personal life is my career, you know what I'm saying?
True.
To where everyone in my personal life is on the same page with me, with my career. They're supporting, they're there every 24/7. When you turn around, you see them, you see me. So if you can actually, being an artist, do the both of those, like, you are not only amazing, but your focus is so further than most artists now that you don't even know where you are, literally. Like, physically you're here, but mentally you're not. So most artists now, they get in a lot of personal trouble
mm-hmm.
because they don't know how to balance that.
True.
So
right.
Once you master that, you'll be set.
You know, Anna May, while I got you here, I don't know if Neil Harp, our engineer, told you,
right.
but we actually want to feature you in the Queen City Bullies magazine that's coming up next. So
she's all smart.
That's maybe that'll be a step toward what you're trying to accomplish as far as getting you out there. We're a worldwide publication. We're in print as well as eMag. And, I mean, we support you. We thank you for allowing us to distribute your music. We enjoy it, and we definitely support what you're trying to do.
You guys are amazing.
This is good.
I appreciate you.
Yeah. All
right.
So, as we do all the time, just to close out the show, Tiffany Taylor looking like a bottle of Pepto-Bismol. I am Amir Smith.
I'm Shauna.
And I'm Tiffany Taylor, repping breast cancer.
Okay. Pepto-Bismol month.
Never forget anime. Always remember.
Okay, anime. Thanks for coming. All right, come back next week. www.queencitybullies.com. Download that app, all right? One. Got all that juicy gossip. It must be 9 o'clock
because I hear them bullies knocking. Contact us at queencitybullies.com or Queen City Bullies.
If we find